and one another important section in mathematics, especially for A-level students, maybe Cambridge, maybe National, and sort of mathematics, further mathematics, combined mathematics. This lesson is quite important. So today I focus on integration. Already we have studied a few parts in integration. I have shown you some videos there. So then today I'm going to discuss another part in area between a curve and a straight line with the support of integration. So you know already how to find the area under a curve with the support of integration. You just integrate that and substitute the limits that they have given inside the boundary equation, then you can find the area under the curve. But in this case, if you look at my figure there, it is clear that I have given a curve as well as a straight line. There is a region bounded by this straight line and a curve. So we are going to find out that particular area. So in order to do that, we should remember integration clearly, right? So in this case, we have got that the equation of the curve as y equal x square minus 2x plus 1, while the equation of the straight line become y equal x plus 1. So we'll see how we can find out this area using integration. First part will be whenever we are trying to integrate a certain function, we need to see what is the easiest method that we can integrate within a short period of time as well as applying the correct rules. So we will see how we can do that. First part is I'm going to identify and find out the points where these two graphs are meeting each other, crossing each other, straight line and the curve. So if we solve the two equations simultaneously, we get that those two points are going to be x equals 0 or x equals 3. So then if I go back to my picture, this x coordinate will be 0, this x coordinate will be plus 3. So those two will work as the limits for our integration part. This also I thought of showing you two different methods that you can apply to find this particular area in this case. So what we are doing is actually we are going to find the area of each part, that means area under the curve as well as area under the straight line in this particular region. Then by the difference of them we can find out the area in between the two curves, right? So I have integrated the first function, straight line function, because it is the one which is above the curve. Therefore we have to integrate that first. Then I substitute the limits there, 0 to 3. Then I get the value there, whatever the constant value. Then I integrate the equation of the or the function of the curve and integrate that after substitution of limits. I simplify that with my previous answer by taking the difference of those two, difference of areas. That is going to be 9 over 2 square, and that means 4.5 square meters. This is one method you can find the area between the curve and the straight line. Next method will be, I'm going to combine these two integration parts as one integration. I'm not going to do separate integrations or separate substitutions, which will take some time, more calculations. So therefore, I take the difference of these two functions first. Then I simplify that, which is quite easy to integrate. Then I integrate and substitute the limits at once. Integrated only once, substituted the limits only once. So we get the same answer. So I think this method is much more appropriate rather than applying the previous method, because time is a very critical factor in mathematics when you answer the questions in the papers. If you take more time, if you take more time to read, if you take more time to understand, then answer the question, check your answers, check your solutions, type in the calculator, get the answer, taking so much time. Therefore, always we are trying to minimize the time, but without forgetting to write down the important methods, right? Therefore, this will be the method. So we'll see one another example how we can do this thing. I look at this first question, you can see that the diagram shows the curve y equal x square and the line y equal 9. So y equal x square is right here, and y equal 9 will be this line. So we have to find the area between these two curves, right? First part will be we have to find the coordinates of points A and B as they have given. Then x coordinate of A will be the lower limit, x coordinate of point B will be the upper limit in integration. So first of all, I get the idea what we are going to do. We find the area between the straight line and the curve using the integration. So what do I do? I separate sheet of paper and let's take a word document. Okay, I hope this will work for you. Okay, first of all I will note down what are the two equations that I have for the two functions that I have right here. So in this case you can see y equal x square and y equal 9. Okay, so I note down y equal x squared and y equals 9, straight line equation. I want to solve these two simultaneously. You can see either side is y, so we can equalize this x square to 9. So simply you can get the answer for the x coordinate there. If x square equal to 9, x will be equal to plus 3, or x will be equal to minus 3. We are done. Then we can substitute these two values to x coordinate there, that will give you 9. That means we can write down the coordinates of capital A as minus 3 comma 9, while the coordinates of B become 3 comma 9. Quite easy. If we go back to our diagram, see, x coordinate of A will be negative 3 because it is just above the negative x axis. This is going to be plus 3 comma 9. Done. Now we are going to integrate the two functions. Before doing integration, identify the correct order. When we want to find this area, we have to find the area under this line. That will be this complete rectangular area minus area of this under the curve. Therefore, in this case, our straight line, our straight line will be coming first. So I go to integration, area equal integration minus 3 to plus 3, don't forget the lower limit and the upper limit, first it will be 9, minus x squared and dx, don't forget dx, we are going to integrate with respect to x variable. This is quite easy, right? I hope this is fine. Now I integrate this. When I integrate this, my answer will be let's see, my answer will be 9x minus x to the power 3 divided by 3. Okay, fine. Then I have to substitute these two limit values, upper limit plus 3, lower limit minus 3. Then what do? I substitute them right here and get my final answer directly. So if I substitute from mind, 9 times 3 become 27. Okay, so 27 minus, if I put plus 3 there, 3 to the power 3, 27 divided by 3, 9, but it is minus 9. Then we have subtraction. Substitute the lower limit. If it is minus 3, this becomes minus 27 as well as minus. If I put minus 3 here, minus 3 to the power 3 become minus 27. Minus 27 divided by 3 become minus 9. With this minus, it become plus. So it will be plus 9. So now we can write the final answer. 27 plus 27 become 54. minus 9 minus 9 become minus 18. So 54 minus 18 become 36. Don't forget to mention square. So we are done. So if I take my answer to the next line, that would be better. So answer is 36 square. If we compare with that answer they have given, it is done. Okay, so this is how you can answer to a question which they have asked you to find the area between a line and a curve with the support of integration. Next question also somewhat similar, so then I will give you a chance to try out that. This is one another question like that. So you better try yourself. I think this is somewhat more regarding a question, right? So I thought of doing this question. Therefore, we'll discuss this question completely. So the diagram shows the curve with the equation y equal x square times 3 minus 2x minus x square. P and Q are points on the curve with coordinates minus 2, 12 and 1, 0 respectively. Find dy by d. First, you have to differentiate this particular function. Therefore, first of all, I'll write down the function that they have given, right? So let's go somewhere here. Y equal x squared into, take a look at the function once again, 3 minus 2x minus x squared. 3 minus 2x minus x squared, right? So we are going to integrate this function, right? Then differentiate this function, I'm sorry. They have also to find dy by dx, right? But you can see that we have product there. Therefore, before going for the integration, I try to simplify this by expanding the brackets. 3 times x squared minus 2x into x squared become minus 2x to the power 3. Then minus x square multiplied by x square become x to the power 4. So multiple powers in this case. Then I can try for the differentiation. You know how to do that, right? 3 times x to the power 2 become 2x. Therefore this will be 6x minus 2 times x to the power 3. X to the power 3 become 3x square. So 3 times 2 become 6. So this will be 6x squared. So I put it right there. Finally, x to the power 4 become 4x to the power 3. You know how to differentiate that. Done. Now we'll see what is our next part. Find the equation of the line PQ. We have to find the equation of the line PQ. So this is not about curve, right? They have asked you to find the equation of the line PQ. So when we are interested in a straight line, we need to know how to find the equation of a straight line when the two points are given. You can see they have given point P is minus 2 comma 12. So I note down somewhere here. P minus 2 comma 12. And Q is going to be 1 comma 0, is it? Yeah, 1 comma 0. So nothing much. Now we know what are the two coordinates. First part will be finding the gradient of the line PQ. So you know how to do that. Y difference over x difference. So gradient of the line PQ is equal to, I do it directly without taking much time. I take in this particular order 12 minus 0 divide by minus 2 minus 1. Minus 2 minus 1. So if I look at this, it will be 12 minus 0, 12 divide by minus 2 minus 1 become minus 3, which will lead you to get the answer as 12 divide by minus 3, which is minus 4. Gradient is done. Now you can apply y equal mx plus d4, otherwise y1 minus y0 method. I like that method, so I try that way. That method will be this y1 minus y naught equals m times x1 minus x0, x1 minus x0, right? So what you have to do, so I'll do a small change. I'll take it as y minus y naught. This as x minus x naught in general, right? Y o naught and x naught are going to be the two coordinates where it should be on the line. You can see both are on the line. So I take 1 comma 0 here. So y minus y naught is going to be 0. Then equal m is gradient, which is minus 4. X minus x naught. X naught is going to be what? If you simplify this, you will get the equation of the line PQ as y equal minus 4x minus 4 into minus 1 plus 4. Done. So that will be the equation of the line PQ. Okay. Then prove that the line PQ is a tangent to the curve at both P and Q. So how can you prove that PQ is a tangent to the curve at both P and Q? Easy. How is it easy? You know that on a curve, if you draw a tangent to the curve somewhere, the gradient of the curve at that particular point is equal to the gradient of the tangent as well. Right? So then we can find the gradient at point P and check whether it is going to be similar to the gradient of line, which is minus 4. And we can check the gradient of the curve at point Q and check whether it is minus 4. If it is minus 4 in both cases, we know that definitely this PQ line will be a tangent to the curve at both P and Q. We know what is dy by dx, right? So no problem. I take dy by dx at point P equal, I substitute minus 2 for this particular expression of dy by dx, right? That is how we check it. So if I substitute, I hope it is visible, this will be 6 times minus 2 minus 6 times x is now minus 2, minus 2 to the power 2 we have plus 4, minus 4 multiplied by minus 2 to the power 3 we have minus 8, right? This will be minus 8. So if I simplify this expression, 6 times minus 2 become minus 12, then minus 6 into 4 become minus 24, minus 4 into minus 8 become plus 32. So if I simplify this, 12, 24 become minus 36, plus 32 become minus 4. Can you see this gradient of the curve at point P is similar to the gradient of the straight line? That means we can tell that tangent to the curve at point P, let's check what is the question. The line PQ is a tangent to the curve at P. So we can tell that the line PQ is a tangent to the curve at point P. So you can try same method by substitution of Q to this expression of dy by dx and check, that will be also minus 4. That means the line PQ will be a tangent to the curve at P as well as Q, right? Okay, then the next part is the area between the curve and the y axis. So far what we did was we found the area between the x axis under the curve and the limits were given from x-axis, x equal minus 1 to plus 2, like that. But now we are going to consider about the area between the curve and the y-axis, and the limit should be then given by y, right? So for an example, find the area between the line y equal x minus 1 and y-axis between y equal 0 to 4. So this is the diagram. Now we are not going to shade between the x-axis and curve or the line. Here I have shaded between the y-axis and the line. So this part you need to find out, and the limits are given from y-axis here. Okay, so what do I do? Express x in terms of y. This is very important. If it is needed to be found with the support of y-axis, we need to express everything related to y-axis in terms of y-axis, right? Y variable. So then I express y equal x minus 1 substitution there, so x become y plus 1. Then after substitution, I equation of the line become y plus 1 in terms of y, integrate that from 0 to 4, then you will get the answer as 12, the square unit. So actually that's what I want to discuss today for this particular integration part. Then if you have any doubts or questions, please comment below the video. I had the other lengths of integration lessons as well, please refer them, get the knowledge, and we will see how we can manage this particular lesson integration in A level. So thank you for joining once again. We'll see you with another video.